Hello and welcome to Something Wicked Entertainment's presentation of Barbara Steele Tribute Weekend. So, just a little bit about what you're about to experience. My name is Kevin L. Powers. I'm the co-festival director and program director of Something Wicked Film Festival and Events, and we here are doing a tribute weekend to celebrate the films and legacy of Barbara Steele. Now, if you've been with us before, you've seen some of the other tribute weekends we've done. What we do is we like to highlight a particular filmmaker or actor or actress and their films that they've done in their past and their filmography in order to kind of help push along the legacy of these great filmmakers who may have been forgotten by modern audiences. We hope that by doing this, that they will open the eyes of newer audiences to some of the achievements of these tremendous talents. So, in the past, we've done Boris Karloff and we've done Edward D. Wood Jr., and now we're doing, of course, Barbara Steele. So we want to thank you for joining us here for that one. Just a little bit about this. What we, you know, Barbara Steele is a consummate professional who has been starring and playing in films for over 50 years. She is still alive with us, and thank you. And if you've been watching the Netflix animated show Castlevania, she plays or she lends the voice to one of the characters for the show. So she is very much with us. So that being said, she has a plethora of films in her filmography, of which we are only going to touch upon a small section. So what we do is we hope that you enjoy the film that you're about to see, and then you seek out other films that she's actually been in, and or stay with us over the weekend to enjoy some of the films that we are screening this weekend as part of our watch party. That being said, normally I might come in and out and say a few words here and there about the films being said. I will probably not do that as much as I normally would because I want you to enjoy the films. I want you to enjoy the performance, and I want you to be able to experience films like I did, not knowing much about it before I watched it. So for a lot of you this who have never seen this film, it will be a welcome shock, a good shock. And for others of you who have seen the film, I hope that you learn to get a greater appreciation of not only the film, but of Barbara Steele's amazing accomplishments as an actress and filmmaker. That being said, I don't want to keep talking. So I'm going to let us all get started with film and then let you decide on your own what you would like to, with your own opinions of her film and her career. That being said, if you enjoy the film, make sure to go out there and support the actors and the filmmakers by purchasing your own copy for your own collection, physical collection, or virtual collection, online streaming collection, because without the continued support of patrons and audiences like you, these films would not be seen, and these actors and filmmakers above the line and below the line cannot continue to make residuals off these films. So our film for right now is the horrible Dr. Hitchcock, of which I hope to enjoy. And I will shut up and let you enjoy the film. All right.
Thank you. won't feel anything. It'll be just as if you were asleep. Prepare the injection, please. Hurry. We must operate before the heartbeats quicken up again. I don't know how long my anesthetic will last. Very variable. Scalpel. I must hurry. My wife has guests and she'll never forgive me for being late.
Professor.
Yes?
Excuse me. There's Inspector Scott who wants to talk to you.
Yes, of course. Ah, good evening, Inspector.
Good evening. Do you think he'll be all right?
Well, he's had a very severe blow, but I've done everything possible for him. All we can do now is hope for the best.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night, Inspector.
The professor's done everything he can. So, don't worry. Your father will be all right.
Good evening, Professor.
Good evening. Oh, Martha.
Yes, sir?
Please tell my wife I'm very tired this evening, and so I'm going straight up to my room.
Everything's ready upstairs, sir.
Thank you, Martha.
I feel very tired.
Please forgive us, my dear. Very well.
Thank you for a lovely evening.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Margaret. Come again soon.
Yes.
Thank you, Doctor.
No, no, no. It is only science your father must thank.
It's a great victory, Professor. It may not be a miracle, but it has all the characteristics of one.
The human body keeps its secrets well hidden. So much time has been wasted in attempts to analyze the soul, while the mechanical, material side of our beings remains an unknown universe.
If you hadn't been able to get that slowing up of the heartbeat, the operation could never have been such an overwhelming success.
Well, I don't know. Perhaps my anesthetic is only useful because it slows up the general action of the organism.
Professor, the patient is ready for the operation.
All right.
Waiting for you.
Margaret! Margaret!
Doesn't it seem strange for the doctor to bury his wife in his laboratory?
Yes, but you must admit the good doctor's a little strange himself, isn't he?
Ah! 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 Ah!
The carriage is waiting.
Thank you, Martha.
Have you decided to leave then?
Yes, Martha, I have. I can't go on living here. Everything reminds me of her. Everything. I shall leave the house in your charge.
All right.
Goodbye, Martha.
Goodbye.
Oh, by the way, where's the cat?
Jezebel disappeared.
Well, goodbye.
Anywhere as long as I'm with you.
I think we're almost there. Bring up the rest of the bags. In the morning. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
I used to keep a laboratory right here on the grounds.
Nature's very prolific. It's only taken a few years to turn this place into a wilderness.
Oh, look. There's someone up there. Who can it be?
It must be Martha, my housekeeper.
It's going to rain.
Yes, come along. We must hurry. Wait a minute, Cynthia. I'll strike a match.
Quite wild. Oh, good evening, Martha.
Welcome home, Professor.
Martha, this is my wife. Cynthia, this is my housekeeper, Martha.
How do you do? You must excuse the state the house is in, but I only had time to prepare the upstairs rooms.
Ah.
Would you like something to eat?
Ah, yes. You must be hungry, my dear.
No. I'm just tired. In that case, Professor, shall I show your wife up to her room if she...
was that?
Nothing. It's my sister. I've had her staying with me here. But tomorrow I'm taking her to an asylum. She's quite mad.
Come on, dear. I'll go upstairs with you.
Why does Martha look at me in such a strange way?
Oh, Martha may appear a little odd, but you'll soon get used to her. Come along. When we get some proper light, it'll be much more cheerful.
It's beautiful. Was it here that she used to sleep?
Yes.
Forgive me, but this house has such a strange effect on me. It's so hostile. I'm scared by all kinds of things, even the cat.
You're just very tired. You'll feel quite differently tomorrow.
Of course.
Now, Martha will bring up your bag, and if you need anything, there's a bell behind your bed.
Thank you.
Good night, my love.
Good night.
Bernard, is that you?
Good morning, my dear.
Good morning.
Now sit down. How do you feel?
I didn't sleep well.
How was that?
You didn't hear anything last night, did you?
No. Why?
After you left me, I'm sure somebody tried to get into my room.
But that's absurd, my dear. Who could possibly do that?
I don't know, but I saw the door handle turn and heard footsteps.
Oh, come now, Cynthia. You were very tired last night. Perhaps you just imagined it.
There was someone at the door, I assure you.
Oh, rubbish, Cynthia. My room is next to yours, and I heard nothing at all. I'm sorry, my dear, but going back to the hospital, after all these years, has put my nerves on edge. Forgive me. Yes?
There's an orderly here from the hospital. He wishes to speak to you and says it's urgent.
Excuse me, my dear. I invite you to a concert tonight. Be ready about 8.
All right. Up there. Why is this door locked? It's always been locked.
Figure.
Professor, there's an emergency at the hospital.
Thank you. Would you excuse me, my dear? I'm afraid I have to go to the hospital at once. Would you see my wife home and then join me at the hospital?
With pleasure.
Good night.
Good night.
Shall we?
Just come over from New York when the professor returned home. And I was lucky enough to find a position here. I've always followed his experiments with great interest.
Oh, really? Don't think that because I married Bernard, I know about medicine.
I wouldn't know, but since you married the professor, you are interested, it seems. You are, aren't you?
Of course.
Find it too boring?
No, of course not.
May I accompany you to the door?
No, thank you. My husband will be waiting for you at the hospital.
to have the pleasure of seeing you again.
I will expect you to call on me. Good night.
Good night.
Someone and wondered who it was. Would you please show me to the house? Come. Please take the cat with you.
All right.
And Martha, will you please leave your sister locked in the lodge?
My sister? She was taken to a clinic in Bath yesterday.
He's getting old.
It shouldn't have happened. The poor woman.
What if you'd used your anesthetic? Perhaps you could have saved her.
No. I shall never use that anesthetic again. It isn't perfected yet. It's too risky.
Professor?
No.
But I can't be mistaken. She had those boots on. I'm absolutely certain those were the ones, even though I only saw her for a moment, standing in front of my door.
All this is utterly ridiculous. Cynthia, you must remember that when I first met you, you had not been well. The shock of your father's death had left you in a highly nervous condition. You seem to be getting over it, but you must not allow your imagination to run away with you.
I know it sounds absurd, but I really saw it, Bernard. I actually saw it. I waited all night for you to come in, but I didn't hear you at all.
I got back extremely late.
Bernard, all these portraits of her, even here in your room. Oh, I know you adored her. But please try to understand. Wherever I go, her eyes seem to be watching me.
All right, Cynthia. I must go. And Cynthia, please remember that when I'm not in the house, I do not wish you to enter this room. I'll see you at dinner.
How nice to see you.
I came to talk to your husband.
Bernard's gone out. Is it urgent?
Oh, urgent? Not very.
Please come in.
How do you like London? What's the matter?
Do you believe in ghosts?
No, I don't.
Neither do I. But ever since I've been in this house, it's been a constant fear to me. I'm beginning to believe in them. I even saw the folds of a dress and a slipper.
Are you sure? It's not possible. You could have imagined it.
I knew you wouldn't believe me, but I'm telling you the truth. In your opinion, is Bernard normal?
As much as any man of genius. But why?
Oh, nothing. Just an idea. Can't I offer you a drink?
No, thank you. I've got to go to the clinic.
Oh.
Anyway, Cynthia, if I can ever help you, please don't hesitate to let me know.
Thank you, Kurt.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Hitchcock.
What do you want, Dr. Lang?
Nothing. It's my turn on duty tonight. I heard a noise, but I didn't think it was you.
I just wanted to check the state of coagulation in this case.
But if you just called me, I would have helped you.
I didn't know you were on duty tonight. Anyway, it's useless. Come, let's get out of here.
Why is this door locked? It's always been locked.
I thought you asked me to look in and say goodnight. Where have you been?
Martha didn't tell the truth about her sister's leaving. She's still here.
Have you seen her?
Yes, I was up at the lodge and saw her through the window. Her back was turned to me.
That's strange.
And another thing, Bernard. What's through that door?
Which door?
The first one there, on the landing.
It's my old laboratory, and I wish it to remain locked.
Bernard, you've changed so much since we got here. Why can't we leave this house now?
I left this house once, and I bitterly regret having done so. I shall not leave it again. Good night. same treatment.
Someone scratch you, Professor.
It was Jezebel, my cat.
Professor.
Yes, Frank?
Your carriage is at the door, Professor.
Ah, yes, my wife is waiting at home. Frank, do me a favor. Go back downstairs and tell them I'll be there as soon as possible.
Yes. Something wrong, Professor?
You have no doubt already understood the situation. It's my wife.
Your wife?
Yes. When I first met her, she'd been undergoing treatment for a shock she'd had. I fell in love with her straight away, and I tried to convince myself she was completely cured.
She seemed quite balanced to me. A little impressionable, perhaps.
She's got it into her head that I don't love her. That I'm still in love with my first wife, Margaret. She even thinks that Margaret's ghost is haunting her.
It's your fault, Professor.
Huh? My fault?
Yes. She feels as if she were a stranger in your house. And the fact that you wish everything to remain as it was makes her think that you still love your first wife. Cynthia feels like a rival. And in her subconscious is this question of doubt.
But that's absurd. Perhaps I may be blamed for having brought Cynthia back here, but this place is full of memories for me. And not all very pleasant ones, I assure you. But one can't run away forever.
To move house would be sufficient.
Maybe. Feeling, my dear. What's the matter?
What happened? What did you do to me?
Nothing. We found you lying unconscious in the garden. You've been quite delirious. Look at the state you were in.
But it's not possible.
I'm afraid, my dear, that your nerves have given way again. However, don't worry. You will soon be well.
Thank you.
Drink this. It'll make you sleep. Martha, don't disturb my wife. She's not well. Oh, and Martha, I think perhaps you'd better go away for a few days. You understand? You can resume your duties a little later on.
As you wish, Professor.
Oh, Martha, I shall never forget what you've done for my poor wife.
Your bag at home. Frank went to get it. Professor?
Huh? Was I late?
Professor?
Yes?
It's Frank.
Ah. Frank. Where have you been? Where's the bag?
There was no one there.
No one in the house? Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. I rang, called, even walked right round the house. Saw no one at all.
Excuse me, Professor. Maybe your wife has gone out on a visit.
But she never goes out by herself. I must go and see if something is wrong. You understand, don't you? Please take over from me.
The moment he wasn't looking, I poured the milk into a flower vase.
Could be Cynthia, that your husband. Surely you don't believe that he.
I don't know. I don't know, Kurt. I've only got you who can help me. Don't you understand? I've only got you.
Yes, Cynthia.
And then last night I woke in a horrible place. And there was Bernard looking at me like some monster.
Oh.
Suddenly I saw these hands grabbing him around the neck. It terrified me. Then I don't know what happened. I must have fainted.
And then?
Nothing. This morning I was in my own room and there was Bernard looking at me. I made him think I'd drunk the milk and then I pretended to be asleep.
I'll have it analyzed, Cynthia. And if the results show nothing wrong, will you admit the absurdity of your suspicion? Anyhow, try to remain calm. Your imagination is much too vivid. Yes, I know. I know it seems real.
Cynthia, I was worried about you. What on earth are you doing here?
Your wife came looking for you, Professor. In your absence, I entertained her.
I see. Well, I think perhaps we'd better go home. Come along, my dear. I sent her away.
You mean you've dismissed her?
Yes. I didn't think you'd mind. In fact, I thought you'd be pleased.
Concentration here to kill a horse.
Are you sure?
Three different tests, the same result in each case. The milk you brought me contains sleeping tablets, enough to give eternal sleep.
But, oh, Cynthia. Oh, no. I might be too late.
Thank you. You must be buried like I was buried. Shut up alive down here. When I got out of my coffin, Bernard had gone. He didn't know. He still loved me. It's you. You who must die.
Everything will be just like it always used to be. I will give you back your beauty with this young blood.
Yes, kill her. Kill her. And then there will be only me. Only me.
Well, that was an amazing film, I have to say so myself. That's a film I've seen many times, so I'm hoping that you enjoy it as much as I do and added it to my your thing. So I want to thank you all for joining us for our 2022 Barbara Steele Tribute Weekend. I hope you join us for some of the other screenings we are having this weekend. And if you are watching this as a recorded video, check out some of the other videos of the other screenings that we did, just so you can get an idea of everything that Barbara Steele did as a actress. With all that, I was like, I hope to see you again. And don't forget, if you enjoy the film, make sure to add it to your personal streaming and or physical media collections, because like I said, every purchase supports the filmmakers and their legacies. And I hope to see you at the next screening. Good day.